So we're going to be talking about using the Zimmer 6.5 cannulated screw system for an ORI up of a hip fracture, otherwise known as a hip pain. So these are going to be the basic steps you're going to need to follow in order to get through this case. So step one, you're going to need some guide pins. We have a trocar tip here. You're going to have that on your Mayo stand, and you're going to use that pen to get some images for their entry site. They're going to next use your cordless driver to drive the pin down into the hip. Then you'll use your pin collet here, which is written on here, and it has the sizes there for you. These are a 3.2 millimeter diameter pin. You'll drive that pin into the hip, into the bone. Step three, next thing we're going to do is we're going to need to put in a total of three pins. So to do that, we're going to use this guide and work to get that through the skin. We're going to make an incision. As you can see, it's fairly large. This will go, we'll make the skin incision, put the Gatling gun, sometimes referred to, this pair of a small pull pin guide. We'll have one pin in the center from the previous step, and then they'll put pins in next to that. And you can put them, as you can see, in multiple places. They're going to use the cordless driver once again to drive those pins down into the bone. Once they have all three pins in, we'll move to step four, and we're going to find out what length screws we're going to need. So we're going to use a depth gauge. These will slide over the pins that are in the hip, and you can read off the end of the depth gauge what screw length you'll need, and they'll call that out, let's say maybe 100 millimeter length. And we'll show you what that looks like. So they can measure all three of those, and they'll typically tell you those lengths, and you can write those down on your Mayo or back table, and you can measure those screws out and have those screws ready to go when they ask for them. Oftentimes you'll have two screw lengths that are the same and one that's a little bit longer. Not always this, but that happens rather often. Then they may choose to over drill on the pins the first cortice of the hip bone if the bone quality is still intact. And as patients age, their bone loses that integrity, so sometimes they may not use this drill. This is kind of an optional. If the bone is soft, they'll forego that step. But I would still have that ready, and that goes on your Jacob's chuck. So that's ready to go. I have it ready to go. Now, back to step four, they gave you some screw lengths. So we'll get some screws out of our screw caddy. Let's say they called for 100 millimeter length screws. Let me move this over here so you can see a little bit easier. And 100 millimeter is right here. So we'll grab one of those from our 100 millimeter slot. We're going to double check and confirm that is 100 millimeters in length, and that is with our screw gauge here in the middle of the tray, conveniently located. These are 6.5 millimeter screws in diameter, and there's a screw gauge here as well to confirm that. We can load the screw on the power screwdriver. You put that on a reamer, and that screwdriver tip gets chucked up, and then we'll put the, we'll select to have the striker reamer set to ream and also to forward. Load the screw onto the tip, and then you'll pass that up to the surgeon and repeating what screw length that you are passing up. So this is a 100 millimeter partially threaded, 16 millimeter partially threaded, 6.5 cannulated screw. It'll take that and it'll drive that down, and it'll drive the this down probably about 90% of the way into the hip, into the bone, and then you'll hand them up the manual screwdriver for the next step, step seven, and they'll finish tightening that up by hand so the surgeon can feel through proprioception that it's at the right position. They'll take some images as well to make sure that it's not too long, not too short. They're going to repeat that process two more times for the other guide wires that are in there. You'll pass up, they'll call out the screw lengths they want. Like I said, they'll usually give you all three lengths so you can have those screws ready to go. They'll just usually fire one pin right after another. Once all three pins are in, there's going to be the three guide wires from earlier that are going to be in. So this is kind of what's happening here. We have three pins in, and then you have the screws on those. The pins need to come out. We're going to go down to our step one, where we get our pin driver, pin collet, and then pull those guide wires out one by one. Sometimes if the bone quality is poor, they can just pull these pins out by hand and they may not even request the cordless pin driver. They'll close that incision that they made with a Gatling gun. So very small incision, a few stitches, put some staples in perhaps, and then a dressing, and that's all there is to it. 6'5" hip pain.